Today, we're going to check out our new beer. But first, let's reminisce and look at a couple of really cool things we did on Shane's Craft Beer Review in 2021. Let's check it out. Hey everybody, Happy New Year. Hope everybody had a really fun and safe New Year's. I was working all last night, so it really wasn't that much fun. But hey, it's okay. It's a new year. We're going to start off New Year's Day right. So before we get into today's beer review, I just want to go back and just kind of do a little flashback of some of the really neat things we did here on Shane's Craft Beer Review. It was a pretty exciting year. We did a lot of really cool things. I got to try out the most expensive beer I've ever had on my channel. And as I was gingerly placing it into my basket, I just happened to look up to see the little price tag that's sitting underneath it on the shelf. $9. $9 for a can of beer. Can you guys believe that? $9. This is better be freaking spectacular, fucking Omnipolo. Let me tell you, $9. As well, we also checked out the highest rated beer that I've ever done on my channel this year as well. $4.75. 4.75 out of 5. There you go. That's how freaking good this beer is. It is delicious. And I believe that's actually the highest I've ever rated a beer on this show in, what did I have, about 240, 250 episodes? Definitely had some really tasty beers. But with the good also comes the bad, because I also had to drink a bunch of sours. God. Yeah, no. No, not at all. Which, of course, also includes this one, which was the worst beer I've ever tried in my entire life. Oh, my God. Oh. Smells sour as hell. God, makes me want to throw up in my mouth already. I haven't even had any yet. Jesus Christ. Yeah, really, really sour smelling. Fruity. It's going to be sour and tart and all the crap I hate about this style of beer. But let's try it anyway. Cheers. Oh my God. Freaking disgusting. Jesus Christ. And of course, I can't mention sours without going back to that one episode where I may have had just a slight meltdown. Sour beer again? Are you guys kidding me? Jesus Christ! I've had it with these damn sour beers. Had enough, I tell you. You know what? I've been tired of these stupid crap, stupid beers. God damn it. You know what you guys can do? You take this can, shove it up your kiss my God damn it. This stupid. But that's okay. You're gonna find beers that you don't like. It just happens. But on the plus side, I did get to meet a whole lot of really, really cool people. A lot of you other beer reviewers. Had a fantastic time meeting you, becoming friends with you, and, you know, doing little collaborations. Like when I went down to Brantford for the first time and met Drew. All right, guys, we made it. We're here in Brantford, obviously, because I have my beer for breakfast, facts for snacks on shirt on. Thanks to my buddy Drew. Drew, hey, nice to see you, man.
Nice to see you. I love this.
I am so excited to be here. I've been watching Drew's channel for a long time, mentioned him a couple times in my videos. And I'm just so happy to be here. And it was like an hour and 15 minute drive for me. It's great. We had an absolute spectacular time together. And the next time we went down to go see Drew, I even talked him into putting in a bikini top while we went and hung out in the pool.
Ah, man, that's great. What a swim. Well.
Hey, Drew, that looks like fun.
Come on in, buddy.
All right.
Let's see.
Woo.
Woo.
What's up, guys? Right.
Guys, we're in the pool, relaxing. Wow, you're right in here too.
Oh yeah, come right in here.
Water or what?
Yeah, okay, absolutely.
Yes! Alright guys, we're doing poppers.
And then there might have been the video where we went just a little teeny bit too far and went topless in the video.
Drew, beer Shame. For breakfast, facts for snacks.
I dropped my snack. We actually had snacks on the show.
Snacks!
actually had snacks on. Drew actually had snacks on Beer for Breakfast, Facts for Snacks.
What are we having? Kielbasa.
Now, as well as me and Drew get along, which we do, fantastic guy. I love hanging out with him. There was that one occasion where I went down there and he tried to make me drink a sour, and we might have got into it just a little bit.
He came to Brantford. We're fucking doing a sour.
No, we're not doing the fucking sour. We're not doing the fucking. You know what? I can fucking. You know, fucking piece. I'll fucking kill you.
What the fuck, Jesus?
Motherfucker! Okay, guys, we're back.
Unbelievable.
All
this over a beer.
But that's okay. We ended up making up, settled our differences like men, and I'm actually really excited to go see him. I'm actually going to go see him in just a couple days. I'm going to drive down there. We're going to do a couple little collaborations, a couple little individual videos. It's going to be really, really fun. Love working with him. Well, besides Drew, I also did a couple little collaborations this year. And one of them, which was really memorable for me personally, was my Beer with Buddies episode. That was the video where I stole videos from TK, Drew, and Mad Dan and put them all into a little collage, and it looked like we were doing a beer review together, except for these guys had no idea because I just stole all their old videos and kind of pasted it up. It was really fun to do. Looked a little something like this. Without further ado, let me introduce TK.
What's up, everybody, and welcome back to A Beer A Day with TK.
I'm now going to introduce to you, Drew.
Welcome back, everyone. It's Drew. It's Beer for Breakfast, Facts for Snacks here. I'm your host, Drew.
Here is Mad Dan.
G'day. Welcome to the Anglers. My name's Mad Dan. There's Marty. And this is the fucking Anglers Grog Review.
That was a really fun video for me to do. It was very, very time consuming to get the proper clips and get everything all organized, but it turned out pretty good. And I think the other three guys were surprised when they saw it because they had no idea I was doing a collaboration with them not even knowing about it. That was fun. I really enjoyed doing that. Another thing I really enjoyed doing was my doppelganger series. If you haven't seen that, that is the one where I did impersonations of Josh, TK, Brian, Drew, and Blue Ice. I knew there was one more, and Blue Ice. And basically, I just impersonated them and their little quirks and stuff like that. And those are fantastically fun to do.
Welcome, everyone, to another half-assed beer review. My name is Josh, and tonight, there's another beer calling our name.
What's up, guys? Drew here. Beer for breakfast. Facts for snacks. Even though we don't do snacks on our show, but Beer for Breakfast, Facts for Snacks. I'm your host, Drew. You guys know who I am.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to A Beer A Day with TK. It's a cold but sunny day here in Findlay, Ohio. Not Philly, Findlay, Ohio. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Hard Pour Pub. My name is Brian, the Beer Snob. Today, we're going to try a new beer.
What's up, guys? Your boy, Blue Ice, in the house.
So as you can see, I like to have a lot of fun here on Shane's Craft Beer Review. And when I was going through a couple of my older videos, trying to figure out what videos I'm going to use for this New Year's Day episode, I came across a whole bunch, and I didn't realize that I sing and dance way, way too much on my channel.
Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake. Shake your milkshake. IPA.
We're gonna try a craft beer. Gonna put it in a glass. But I better not have too many, or my wife will kick my ass.
I'm dreaming of a white beer. Just like the ones I used to know.
Hazy Town. Kinda reminds me of that song.
Won't you take me to Hazy Town?
because I don't feel that there's a need to have, you know, flashing lights or music or dancing girls all over the place. But it sure helps, doesn't it? Woo! Yeah, that's just embarrassing. I don't know what the hell I was thinking. Always embarrassing myself. That's just what I do. Like that one time I pretended to be a DJ. Well, it's 12 o'clock and you guys know what that means. That's right, another live show from Shane's Craft Beer Review. Today we will be taking on a delicious beer, trying it out, and rating it. It's going to be awesome! Or, do you guys remember that time I actually had the gall to pretend to be a priest? Dearly beloved, welcome to the Church of Shane's Craft Beer Review, where we will be saying goodbye to our good friend, the Saint of Circumstance. Before we get into today's service, I think that we should all pray. If you could turn to page number 1 in your Shane's Craft Beer Review prayer book, and let us do the beer prayer. Anyway, they were all a lot of fun to do, and I appreciate it. And I wouldn't do them if I didn't have great guys like you watching my channel all the time. So anyway, enough reminiscing, let's get into today's beer, shall we? Today, from Railway City, we have the Jumbo IPA. This is a 6.8% alcohol by volume, 68 IBU. According to the can, the taste is bold citrus, candied peach, warming, and staggeringly bitter. All right. And I even got a hop list. I never have a hop list. Here's a hop list for you guys. Hey, something new for the new year. This is made with Simcoe, Amarillo, Citra, and Mosaic. I am excited to try this. I think Drew tried this a while ago. I have not tried it. You guys know I'm a big fan of IPAs. And hey, why not start the new year with a delicious IPA? So enough of me talking, enough of me reminiscing. Let's get this in the glass and review it and do what I do on my channel. All right. I was going to say, not a whole lot ahead on this one, but yeah, there it goes. It comes. Be patient. Beer, drinking beer is all about patience. All right. It's kind of a little amber color there. A little lighter than I was thinking, I think, maybe. That's all right. Give her a quick little nose here. Oh, that smells yummy. You can smell those hops in there. Lots of citrus. You can even smell that little bit of peach in there, too. It smells fantastic. All right. Can't wait to try this. Happy New Year's, guys. Cheers. That is pretty, pretty tasty. The body's a little bit on the lighter side. And for, what did I say it was, 68 IBU? I wouldn't say it was 68 IBU. Apparently it is, though. It's not overly bitter. You do have that nice little bitterness in there, but it's not overly bitter at all. Getting that hoppiness, the sweetness, the citrus fruits, touch of the peach in there. It's not bad. A little bit of sweetness in it, too. But overall, not a bad beer at all. I would buy this again, for sure. All right. And because it's a new year, I'm going to change my rating system. I am no longer going to rate beers out of 5. I'm going to do the 2 thumbs up method. 1 is if I would drink it again, and 1 is if I would buy it again. So would I drink this again? Absolutely. I would give it 1 thumbs up for I would drink it again. Would I buy it again? Yeah, it's a good beer. I like this. I would definitely buy it. So this beer, for our first day of 2022, gets 2 thumbs up. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoy the rest of your year and everything just works out perfectly and we get through all this crap that we're going through right now. And I hope everybody has just a fantastic year. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you next time.